Hey guys, welcome back to Front Seat Driver. I'm Jason. Today we're going for a pretty interesting little trip away, and we're not really going away. I'm not leaving town, but we are going to Love Field. We're meeting up with Lamborghini Dallas, and we're going to check out some jets or a jet. Honestly, I really don't know what we're doing, but it sounded fun, and I'm meeting up with some other friends some that have Lamborghinis as well, and also Braden from Alpha Fleet. I don't know. It's on Instagram. We're friends on Instagram. I will put a link to his bio because he's going to be there with me. But anyway, hope everybody enjoys this. Thanks for watching. We are pulling into the hangar. What about that? What about that? Oh, yeah. This is dreams that I've had since I was a child to be able to come to a thing like this. This is awesome. Brand new Lamborghini Huracan Evo. I've never seen one in person. It looks better than I expected. I wasn't a huge fan when I've seen it in photos. I definitely thought the Performante was gonna look a lot better, although I still think it needs a wing in the back. Check that out. I do love these wheels. And my first time yet to see a Lamborghini Aventador in person, the SVJ. Drive carbon on the wing. J on the side. The Italian flag. What do you think? I'm guessing 5-ish, 100,000. Let's see what it says. 542, not bad. But that awaits. I'm gonna go check out some jets. Check out the inside of this. Looks like a little display that's like on the Tesla. Looks like a little iPad. Crazy, man. This thing is, look at the interior. All the blue stitching, blue inserts. Thing is super nice. This one is for sale. Huracan Evo. Got 96 miles on it. Here we are. Inside of this really nice jet. I think Trump's on his way. All right, guys, what do you think? Should we add it to the list? Damon and them add everything to the list, and they seem to get so many cars. Maybe if I add a jet to the list, then I can get another nice car. That's what I think. Sounds good to me. And look, they're pumping in air conditioning just because it's Texas and it's always hot. But this thing is so, I love this. Check it out. Dice? Vice? I don't know what that says. D-nice? I have no idea. You can plug in your iPod. Or I guess it has its own iPod, I don't know. But this is a Challenger 300, Bombadier Challenger 300. I'm telling you, man, this thing is awesome. There's the lavatory. Even has a little reading material for while you're sitting down relaxing. But I can actually walk all the way straight up through here. I'm 5'10 and I have no trouble walking through here. As you can see, not bad. So we are in the cockpit here. Man, I have never seen so many buttons. But there is the view from the cockpit. I don't know how well you can see out of there. There's Performante, red SVJ. A bunch of Huracans, a couple Gallardos, looks like three Gallardos, mine and a couple of others. There's another white SVJ out of here. But check this thing out. I couldn't imagine knowing how to fly something like this. Let's spin around here. There is a coffee maker. That is the most important feature of this plane, of this jet, is the coffee maker. And there is a safe. And I'm not vehicle virgin, so you're not going to get the most awesome tour. But check this thing out. Let's go in the back. Oh, I feel air conditioning blowing in. Oh, look at this. I guess this is an option. Haha. Nice little restroom here. The lavatory. I'm gonna sit back and fly in style. Got a television right here. How's it going?
Good.
Making a video.
Nice, no problem.
This place is really decked out. Oh, another television. See, just like my house. TVs everywhere. Oh, sorry. Check out Lamborghini Urus. Cockpit on this one as well. Again, just so much to know how to do to fly a jet. You know what this is called, right? The OS handle. I won't use the words. See? Nice and full. This is how you travel. That's traveling DDE style. They need to start their own jet service. Daily flown exotics. Look at this Lamborghini Gallardo Superleggera Verde Ithaca Green. This, for me, is probably my favorite Gallardo. And look at all of the exposed carbon fiber on here. It is all Alcantara interior. All carbon fiber on the interior. Superleggera seats are, man, amazing looking. This is, like I said, probably my favorite Gallardo available. I love the Super Trofeo Stradale. And the Squadra Corsa are also my other two favorite. But something about this particular Superleggera, ah, so awesome. And I've seen this guy on YouTube. I can't remember what his name is. But I love this wrap on this Gallardo. And he's got the other wing I had thought about getting, but I think if you get this wing, you have to drill into the body, and I don't want to do that. But I love these white wheels. Strad, this is your brother right here. The yellow Gallardo. Spider. The LP560-4. Both beautiful cars. And then Justin, horsepower obsessed buddy, here's your spec on the SVJ. I know you're a Performante guy, but this SVJ, I gotta tell you, I don't know, man. You might want to pick this one over the Huracan Performante. Looks like it was signed by somebody from the Cowboys. I know we had an event here a while back. My favorite color, blue, on this Lamborghini Huracan Performante. Definitely one of my favorite cars. The ALA system, man. He's actually getting rid of this car. This is the last day with this car. He is going back to an Aventador. He's getting a 2014 Lamborghini Aventador, so I would look forward to seeing that. And of course, you have me. I'm here as well. And I still have my old Callisto wheels, and they're staying since I'm getting new tires. Check this place out, man. How awesome is this? I'm having a blast, hope you guys are too. So this is the inside of a Lamborghini Aventador SVJ. Doors up. The seats are extremely tight. I assume these are the racing seats. I don't know, because I am not an SVJ aficionado, but they are very tight. This one actually has 38 miles on it. This is brand new. Again, this is the one's 542,000. But these seats are really, really comfortable, but really tight. Nice steering wheel. This is one of 900. So I'm gonna go ahead and order this one. I'm gonna go ahead and pay for it today. I'll probably drive it home tomorrow. And don't be surprised if you don't see it in my garage, because I'm not really gonna buy it. But look at this. However, getting out of this thing is a brutal beast. You have to climb out, up, and over. Exactly. See, this is how you try to get into this thing. It is not easy. It is not easy at all. How's the door?
Hard to open.
It is or is not?
It's open, easy to open, but it's kind of hard to close.
Hard to close, yeah. Kind of heavy.
Porsche has the BRS has these straps here.
Yeah. I like the straps. This car is really nice. I mean, look at the ceiling.
Look at the, all the carbon.
It's crazy. Oh, and even better.
Is the engine bonnet carbon?
Oh, I can't tell. But just the view from the back is awesome.
I think Ross is his car. He's got the carbon fiber.
Does he? So we just left. There's Anthony right here beside me.